Hey y'all, it's Ryan, and today I want to tell you all about how we and others measure inflammation in the lab and the different sources of inflammation that we may be interested in based on our research question. Okay, so you probably hear the word inflammation or anti-inflammatory a fair amount in your daily life now, right? Not only has it become a hot topic in health psychology, but it's also become sort of catch-all in the health and wellness world. We measure inflammation by measuring cytokines, which are soluble proteins released by other cells that can regulate immune responses and inflammatory conditions. Cytokines can be either pro or anti-inflammatory. So what distinguishes the different types of inflammation from others is where those cytokines are measured from. Are they measured from your blood, nose, or from part of a blister wound? If they're from your blood, are they measured in serum or from peripheral blood mononuclear cells? Finally, which specific cytokine are you measuring? All of these questions I use to evaluate what kind of inflammation is being discussed and what the effects of higher or lower inflammation might be in this specific context. Okay, let's dive in. First, let's think about local acute inflammation and some of the functions that it serves. Acute inflammation is an immediate response to a pathogen that's transient, and there are a few telltale signs of acute inflammation, including redness, heat, pain, and swelling. When we get a wound, for example, neutrophils, macrophages, and lymphocytes flood the area and produce cytokines, which help to execute this coordinated response. And you can check out the linked video above for more about this super cool process. But here, pro-inflammatory cytokines are so important for healthy, normal wound healing. So when researchers measure the production of cytokines in that wound, lower levels would indicate poorer immune function. Another example of local inflammation occurs when you have an upper respiratory infection, like the common cold. Here, local pro-inflammatory nasal cytokines cause the symptoms that we experience when we're sick. So the pro-inflammatory nasal cytokines can cause people to have worse symptoms when sick with something like the common cold. Okay, let's move to measuring inflammation, so cytokines, in the blood and what that means. There are two different methods that we use in our lab to assess overall sort of bodily inflammation, and both come from a blood draw, but we use different parts of the blood for these two measures. To assess overall systemic, so just cytokines floating around in your blood, we measure the cytokines in the serum part of your blood. So we use a centrifuge to separate the blood cells from the serum, which ends up looking about like this. Another way we can measure inflammation from a blood draw is to isolate the peripheral blood mononuclear cells, so think T cells and monocytes, and measure how many cytokines they produce when exposed to a toxic pro-inflammatory stimulus of some kind in the lab. And we call these stimulated cytokines. And they better represent your immune system's reactivity to stress than just measuring the cytokines that are floating around in your serum. Another reason we've been using stimulated cytokines over serum cytokines in our research lately is because cytokines are produced and have a very short half-life, which means that they oftentimes people with low levels of serum cytokines may actually have undetectable levels of serum cytokines, which isn't really that helpful when we want a continuous variable. So stimulated cytokines let us definitely detect cytokines and understand how specific immune cells respond to stress. So we use these serum and stimulated cytokines in our lab as an indicator of cardiovascular disease risk because pro-inflammatory cytokines, especially this one cytokine called interleukin-6, is really involved in the building up of plaques that cause atherosclerosis. So today we talked about local versus systemic inflammation, and I gave you a few different examples of why you might measure local cytokines instead of systemic cytokines. Hopefully this helps you parse out some other research or just helps out in your daily life as a consumer of so much information. Thanks for stopping by, and please click like or subscribe for more videos like this.